guys, introducing my bestie here.
I'm here again.
What's your name? She's V, she's my friend, she has always been with me. Kwanzia jana tulipoanza tour yet, we exist with her, guys. And today we are here in Gedi rooms. You're just here to see snakes?
Yes.
Okay guys, be with us till the end of this video.
Adventure with us?
Yeah, tour with us. We will show you everything that is inside this place and we'll be happy when you keep in touch with us. Welcome, Gedi rooms.
I hope we won't forget to shoot. Yesterday we forgot.
Oh my gosh, and what I forgot to tell you guys, Tumepotea, this place is far away from Malindi. We almost got lost on our way here.
And almost gave up.
But thanks be to God, Tumefika safe and we're here.
Yeah. Come with us.
Ilikuwa na gate, west gate, south gate na east gate. So, na outer wall ilikuwa na north gate na northwest gate. The inner wall ilikuwa dominated by the rich. The rich peke yao ndio walikuwa naishi hapa katikati. The hapa katikati kulikuwa au economic middle class. Alafu outer kulikuwa the poor. Hii ilikuwa 7 feet high. 7 feet high, hii wall utaiona. Hii ilikuwa 9 feet high. Yeah, so, hapo kawe ulikuwa maskini, haungejihusisha sana na tajiri, haungepata.
So guys, as the tour guide has explained there, this was a city where the Portuguese were living. And he has told us that it was divided to three classes. There were those of high class, the medium and the low class, and they were all living in different places, and there are places that those of low classes couldn't go. So as you can see down here, these are the sites, and if in every place there are people who are living there, they also have their tomb inside here. And because, let me just summarize this by just showing you the videos about the place, and then I'm gonna do an interview with the tour guide after I'm done with this tour. Come with me and see what I'm shooting, and I hope you guys are going to understand. Again, after having the tour in the ruins, we had to come to the snake park. But you know, I'm always scared by the snakes, so I don't like anything to do with the snake. I didn't even enter the room. I just gave someone to go and record the videos for me. And let me just show you. I'm even afraid of editing the video, but let me just show you whatever was there. I'm not even going to explain anything about it. Can see they have reared different types of snakes. I don't even know their names, but whatever you can see guys, they're the snakes inside Gedi rooms in their park. So watch And maybe if you know the types of snakes, you can be able to differentiate. But for me, I can't explain anything about them. Just literally.
The monkeys here are so, they're not friendly. I wanted to lie. They're not friendly, but they have eaten our bananas. Now I'm at Pandia, so I was scared. So
why were you scared? Mimi,
so like after we didn't capture that moment.
Mimi, the only thing that have scared me here is the snake park. Tell me about the experience, you know. Cobra.
No, it's not a cobra, I've forgotten the name. Inalia. And then
inajinusha kichwa juu.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. That's why I didn't go there.
You know, people from my Instagram know I love snakes.
You do?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
I've been in National Kenya Archives, yeah, the one in Nairobi. And I captured snakes. I love the way they move. Yani, there's something about snakes. Their movement is pleasing to the eye.
So guys, I'm having a tour guide here. This is the person who has been taking us through this route. So I want him to introduce himself and tell us about this place because we already have the experience. Hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Philip.
Philip?
I'm a tour guide. I'm a guide from Gedi National Monument.
So for how long have you been here?
For a year.
Okay, so Sam, I want you to explain me about this rune, Gileilianza, and some little details about it.
Okay.
Gediru. You can use any language.
Okay, Gedi ruins was established in 12th century. Then it came into its climax in the 15th century. Then it was abandoned in the 17th century. The main inhabitants of Gedi town were Swahili, which came intermarriages between Arabs and coastal Bantus. The main reason why the city was abandoned, one was plague disease. Plague disease was brought out by rodent, which they consumed the same food as the occupant, the Swahili. The another thing was dryness of wells, which was brought out by the geographical changes, where the water disappear suddenly. Then they continued to dug down, but the water was salinity, it was saline. Another thing was Gala invasion. Gala, they are Cushitic speaker from Ethiopia. They are the same as Oromo. So they came, they were finding the pasture. They are looking for the pasture for their livestock. So when they found the Gedi town as a suitable place, where they brought the name Gedi, which means a precious for the Oromo. The another thing was the civil war, which was brought out between the Sultan, of Malindi, Sultan of Mombasa, and Sultan of Zanzibar. So the civil war was brought out by Portuguese, Vasco da Gama, who was finding his way to India. Yeah.
Okay. And because we have seen that the houses are very old, is it that they were like that, ama zimebomoka too?
No, the house ilifanywa excavation.
Yeah.
So when they abandoned the city, we are talking about 17th century.
Yeah.
So the place remained without anyone there. So
ikaanza kubomoka. Yeah. Nilikuwa na shangaa vile sasa unasema they are living here yet kuna hata tuone vile ilikuwa construction. So it was a good house like this.
Yeah, it was a good house. Oh. As you saw the bathtub, the place where the bathtub was.
And sasa vile miaka inaendelea kwenda si itabomoka ishe ibaki hivyo bila.
No, according to the maintenance, that's why tukiwa na tour, our tourists. Na advice wasikanyagi hizo walls, wasikanyagi, wasitembele, they walk through the...
Na kuna any nini, like, itakuwa rebuilt?
Tukirebuild, tunaribu history.
Okay, so it will just remain like that for historical purpose? Okay, that's nice, thank you.
Few moments later.